They need points over these next couple of weeks, and they need them badly, as do the Blues. So we expect a very intense game tonight. And there's a shot and a glove save to begin for Hofer. Balk in a race. Leans into Anders Lee. And the puck played by Thomas right between the circles. Pollock tees up a wrister. Save made. Hofer scrambles for it. In the blue paint. It was cleared out by Krug.
Just over 4 minutes in, and look at this work by Captain Anders Lee, just using his body position and hustle to get down there. And they, again, take advantage. They force the turnovers by putting the pressure on the defenseman, and it's Ryan Pollock who does a good job right here. He takes a little stick handle, finds a lane, making sure that that shot is not going
to... Lost it to Barzal. Barzal gets the cycle going, stops to activate, throws one in front, off the chest of Hofer, and he immediately found that rebound.
Good pressure early on here by the New York Islanders. You know, it's smart by them too, knowing this team is off a back-to-back in a shootout.
Nelson with a drop, a dangle by Barzal, and a stick save by Hofer. He creates some havoc on the forecheck with Toropchenko and Sundqvist working the boards, but now the Islanders get it the opposite end. That shot again, sticked away into the netting by Hofer.
Knocked off the President's winning team, Boston Bruins, and went on to the finals.
Cutting to the net, Kyrie, shower in on Sorokin, and he covers up.
All three of those games, so they're making him count.
Lee across the line, softly to the corner. Pageau fields it there. Point to point it goes to Dobson. Wrist shot, tipped over the net by Lee. And to the high glass behind Hofer. He'll feather it deep. Saad. Away from Riley. Neighbors moves it back to the point. Long wrister. Save with the blocker. Through traffic in front by Sorokin. Saad tries the cycle. It's loose along the half wall. Saad keeps it alive. Out in front for Shen. Sorokin plays it to the wall himself. Nelson is there with a stick lift. They can't clear. Neighbors spins one to Krug. Wrist shot in front. Loose. It ends up side of the net. Holmstrom, Brother Romanov trying to swing one towards the net, and Robert Thomas comes back the other way. Center circle across the Islander line with a drop. Kyrou, wrist shot, that was blocked. Another try, and a save made by Sorokin. Anders Lee brings it back. When you were tired, when the opponent wasn't, how did you combat that? How long did you find it took for you to get your legs so that maybe you were on equal footing with an opponent that's a little more rested than you might be?
You know, I'm with Coach Drew Bannister. 10 or 12 minutes, you get a couple of shifts in and you sort of have to shake off that rust. I think a lot of it is a mental challenge, and you always hear about that from sports psychologists. All you can control is that next shift. Go out, give it your effort, give everything you got, no matter what. Whether it's on a back-to-back or whether it's just one of those games you don't have it, that's all you can control. Next shift.
Nelson out in front. Caught just wide by Barzal. Gains the red line. Skies it in across the Blues line. McLean with a reach. Puts it behind the net. Mark out in front, hoping for Clutterbuck. And that's intercepted by Kapanen. And he'll risk a stretch pass. Hayes in stride with a drive. Save made by Sorokin. Possible numbers through center for the Islanders. Romanov gains the zone, drops one off to Horvat. Tough to pass, it's a giveaway. Neighbors and outlet, Toropchenko. Shen goes to the net, two on one. Toropchenko, score! He picks the corner. A giveaway by the Islanders at one end becomes a two on one at the other. And Alexei Toropchenko makes no mistake.
Horvat then thinks he has support, has a backhand pass, it's a little bit blind, and it sends an odd man rush the other way. Not a lot of back pressure. It's a two-on-one, and it's Toropchenko coming off the bench. So not only does he have a full tank of gas, but he's also got the read, and he's got a build.
He found it when he was playing. It should just be one voice that the goaltender hears. And even early on in his coaching career, a giveaway, and right on the doorstep.
Another look. I was almost wondering if it just hit the back and the net came out quick, but
pads it to the corner. Thompson deep. Behind the net, Horvat. Right between the circles. Nelson on net. Another pad save made by Joel Hofer, as he has been perfect so far, stopping all 16 Islanders shots.
Navid does a great job closing the gap on Nelson there.
Scandella towards the net. Loose in front. Score! Kyrou finds the loose change as the Islanders fumbled the puck right in front of Sorokin. It looked like Saad with a little stick lift helped keep it alive for the goal by Kyrou.
Nelson high in the slot, and Buchnevich presents that Good transition here for the St. Louis Blues. They get it. You can see in the background there, they're getting changed, fresh legs, and they go to work. And all it is a simple play by Saad. He's behind Horvat. Horvat has no idea he's there. Can't see it here, but Riley doesn't recognize the back door, and he's thinking out.
Tillich, long wrister, that's blocked down by Parayko, but a takeaway from Barzal. Sets up Horvat. Oh, no! The rebound after the homer save. Just eluded the stick.
How about that hard work by Cizikas defensively and then the speed to the neutral zone?
Islanders struggle in the second period.
Watch this whole line that he's been playing with. Great transition. One thing the Islanders have done well, they tried to transition with passes as opposed to with their feet. Great look up, great pick up by Palmieri to stay onside.
Hofer plays the puck. Falk is there. Chips it off to Brayden Schenn. Good stick by Horvat. Throws one out in front. Saved by Hofer. Oh, he took one away from Nelson. The two teams that right now are in the first spot on the outside looking in the Eastern and Western Conference playoff races. The Blues with the 2-1 advantage. Aho with a shot.
Two center by J.G. Pageau. Here they are in the face-off. Great work by the team. All three guys to win that face-off. It's not just about the center. And then all night long, these three guys have crashed the net. We've noticed it over and over.
Try and take advantage. Just be sound in their own end as best they can. As Horvat brings it across. With speed. In on net. Hofer makes the save. Wrap around. Score! What a play!
Awfully smart right now. Good transition. Good look through the neutral zone. Earlier they had a quick pass through, but that was they skated it through. And then before that is the definition of tenacity. He stays on Nick Leddy there. Former Islander Nick Leddy stays with it, goes around, and Joel Hofer. I think Hofer thinks he has it right there.
Krug center circle. One touch across to Thomas. Behind it, and Kyrou leaves it for Buchnevich. Back to Thomas. Shoot, save made with the blocker by Sorokin. Buchnevich right back to Thomas. Along the goal line, out in front. Tarrant's off the skates of Pelech. And Sorokin was ready. Covers it up on the edge of the crease. Horvat puts it behind the net. Buchnevich is there. It's freed up. Barzal weaves his way through center. Barzal to the empty net. Scores!
It's a mass exodus now with 30 seconds left, but great look from Matt Barzal. He could have, on the right shot there, he could have just looked up and gone for the empty net. He trusted his skates, he trusts his hands, and he's able to weave through and come in all alone. And I guess he's not going to take a slap shot in close, as we saw from another game earlier this year.
Terrific response from the Islanders and a frustrating loss for the Blues. They score the first 2 points of the game. They've got a 2-0 lead in the second, and the Islanders answer with the next four to get two huge points.